And we're back.
Take three.
So Heather is about to read you an awesome quote that she put on her Facebook wall this morning. And I saw it, and it was just so perfect with everything that we're up to and what our topic is. So
awesome. Yeah, so there's 58 likes on this quote, which is awesome. It says, "You can make more friends in 2 months by becoming interested in other people than you can in 2 years by trying to get other people interested in you." Dale Carnegie. And it's really cool because a lot of the leadership stuff that we do, it's like, be interested, not interesting.
Yeah.
You know, and it's really, people feel really heard and accepted by you when you're interested in them and when you're asking them questions and when you genuinely are asking questions. And it's a great way to connect with other people. And it goes back to who are you being, not what you're doing.
So
it's
true.
Really important.
The most valuable thing that you can give to anybody is your time. So it's just, when I read that, it really resonated with me because what I'm up to every single day, my mission is to motivate and inspire as many people as possible to not only be leaders of their own lives, but to love who they are, their authentic selves. And we oftentimes get kind of caught up in the head conversation of like who we are, but like that conversation is kind of like really what we've become based on past experiences with life. And we tend to lose touch with who we authentically are, like who we were born into and what gifts that we have to offer and like what we're here for and what our purpose is. So I really love today's topic because I really, you know, every single day I'm loving the experience of being free. I haven't worked for anybody else in like 8 years. I mean, I've taught classes here and there at studios, but for the most part, I mean, I've just really been doing me and focusing on how I get to share my message and my gifts and like what I'm up to really contribute with this world. And it's been really interesting. So freedom for me is like being able to color outside of the lines and like have your own flair, have your own style, having your voice be heard and not trying to be somebody or something else. And anytime I've ever tried to like teach somebody else's method of fitness and I've kind of like tried to adapt their kind of thing because I was teaching a certain class for somebody else or it never felt right. Like I never felt like I could really like be myself and trying to be crammed into this like container that like I'm never meant to be in a container of any kind whatsoever. Like nothing in this universe wants to be caged. Nothing in this universe wants to be tied down, held back, pushed away or pushed into something else. And freedom is not ever having that experience. And for me, like I just, there's absolutely nothing wrong with working for somebody else, but to really experience freedom on like a totally new level that most people never really get to experience is being your own boss and really declaring what you want your day to look like what time you're going to get up and what time you're going to go to bed and being able to get together with powerful people in your life. Like every single Wednesday, I hang out in a park outside and do yoga and dance and like move my body and get connected to my movement. And I just love myself and I hear positive, empowering shares and I get to contribute and to be a part of something like that. Like if I were working a 9-to-5, I'd never be able to do that. And so I think that like for me, especially at this point in my life, like really, really getting like how free I really am is so beautiful. And I want that so badly for other people because I know like there are people in my life who have a 9-to-5 and they don't ever get to work out and do a spin class at like 12 noon or like go running on the beach with their best friend and then go get a manicure or whatever. And so we really are the authors of our own lives. Like we really get to create everything and anything that we want. And every single day, like I wake up and my biggest thing about freedom, because we talked about like our definition, and I said that my definition of freedom is not having any obligations. Like I have commitments, I have things that I'm up to and that I'm absolutely dedicated to. Like I have amazing clients and I have scheduled appointments with them, but they are such an amazing part of my life and they add joy to my life. They make my heart double in size every single day, which I don't think is freaking possible that it could ever get bigger, but it does. And it's just like, it's amazing how I get to continuously reinvent myself, not based on anybody else's guidelines or expectations, or you have to be here by this time and make sure that's on my desk at 3 p.m. Like,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so, you know, like I forget sometimes, I really do. And that's why today was so important for me because I really got to really appreciate what I've created for myself and how I am able to continuously give every single day. And I started my own company 7 years ago and it's kind of evolved and turned into other things and blossomed and become what it is today, which is I'm on a mission. And the acronym is IOAM. When you look at it, it says I am, which is this amazing hat that she's wearing, we're all wearing. And it's really like, we all resonate with it. So it's totally great. But really, it's cool for me because what I've created by just being myself and not try to be what somebody wants me to be or be something outside of myself to feel like I'm enough, I've allowed this to blossom into something that's reaching people all over the world. And when you are authentic and you are free to be who you are, then it's an invitation for other people. And they want that. Everybody really wants to be free and move their body and just say what they want and be what they want to be. And we are that every single day. And it's so cool because we're standing as what is totally allowed to be a normal thing. Like, it's not, I think for a lot of people, it's not normal to be free and to be who you are. But this is our standard. This is what we do every single day. We are who we are. Right, girl?
Absolutely. That's right. Thank you so much. I have a, put, I'm going to put a different twist on freedom for me right now. And I totally agree, when you take charge of your life, there's a freedom to that, becoming an entrepreneur and taking a risk on yourself. Absolutely. So I love you. Ms. Cullen for love Operation you. Freedom. Absolutely. When I think of freedom, to me, what I think of is my truth. And really being okay with whatever that looks like. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's the most scariest thing when you know what it is that you feel inside you have to do, but we don't always do it. And when you take that step and you have that faith and that intuition, it's interesting because Monica today, it came up, I said, I feel it here. And I said, well, what chakra is that? And she goes, well, that's faith and intuition. And if there was ever a time in my life where my intuition, I feel like I'm walking intuition, it's been now. And it's really because I'm breathing, living, speaking, visioning my truth. And it's sometimes it's the scariest thing in the world because there's decisions that I've had to make that are so scary and uncomfortable. And they aren't safe. For me, they aren't the safest decisions to make. But when I don't honor that, I feel trapped. And when I say that I feel trapped, I don't know if you've experienced this, ladies, and for those of you out there, that I can't breathe. Mm-hmm. It consumes me in such a way when I am not true to who I am that I feel like I can't breathe. And Monica again mentioned, well, is it breath from your lungs or is it a deeper breath? And I can tell you that when you do that, there's a freedom. I even think the word, I don't even know if the word is freedom, but there is just something that shatters and breaks, and it's like you recreate. There's something so much bigger that happens. Mm. And again, I just want to say that it may be one of the scariest things that you have to do. And it may be, you know, you may consider, am I going to be an outcast? Because this is what I feel. And this isn't what everyone is doing. And all I have to say is that's okay, because that means that's not what you're supposed to be doing. It absolutely means it's not what you're supposed to be doing, and having the faith that what's on the other side is so much bigger. Mm-hmm. And I think it leads to not playing small. When you live your truth, I feel your truth is so big. It's supposed to be so big. And when you step into that side, you feel more alive than ever. So when I think of freedom, that's what I think of. And I want to talk about a relationship that I was in, and that's really where this whole thing came from, because I was in a relationship, and I'm going to take a step back. I was in banking for 9 years. I don't know if many of you know that. Some of you may know that, and I was never free. I was never free, but it looked good. It sounded good, and the money felt good, but my soul didn't feel good, and the money felt really good. I can't lie, and that's what kept me there for so long. Then I was in a relationship, and initially it was amazing, but something just wasn't right. Something wasn't right, and it was probably the scariest decision that I had to make, because I felt like I couldn't breathe again, and I just fully didn't understand that until now. I wasn't free. I wasn't true. I wasn't living in my truth, and I can tell you that I feel like a 4-year-old Christy, a 12-year-old Christy. There's just this light. I can look at people and be so present and be so real. And I think when you do that, you see that in other people. Mm-hmm. Like you mentioned, when you do that, the only thing that gravitates to you, that sticks to you, is truth. Mm-hmm. Because everything else just kind of like, it doesn't stick. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you question, am I tripping? Like, what's wrong with me? No, honey, you're not tripping. You're in your truth. And when you don't sense that, not that there's a wrong or right. You just, you feel it. Mm-hmm. I feel it here. That's where I feel it. So I say freedom is truth. To me, freedom is raw truth. It's real truth. But it's also compassionate truth. Yeah. Compassion. So when you speak from that place and you want to have the conversation that probably isn't so comfortable, that kind of gets you over here, right? Mm-hmm. I think when you say things with compassion and respect, you can never go wrong. Mm-hmm. You can never go wrong. And then you sleep really good at night. You sleep so good at night.
So as we move into our action gems, I want to remind everybody of that mission that we have, that intention that we have of how big can you give. And our intention today is really to invite you to really step into what does freedom look like? What does it feel like? What is your expression of freedom? And when you visit our W.E. Change the World on Facebook, W.E. Change the World on Facebook, you really have an opportunity to share. What is that freedom for you? And we'll get to comment back and share with you. And the other invitation that we really want to leave you with is the movement that we have, the expression of our physical, our nutrition, our health, goes much deeper than just an everyday practice. It goes into sharing that practice with others. And we here as a group of women really can support you in whatever journey, whatever movement, whatever steps you'd like to take towards that goal, towards a fitness goal, toward a health goal, toward an overall wellness goal. And we, each of us, can really support you in that journey. So we invite you to reach out, to seek our guidance, our help, our experience, questions that you may have. And we ask you, what do you love to do? What are some of the things that you love to do? What are some of those things that provide you with that access to the freedom? And then lastly, moving your body every day to give you that freedom and that expression of what your heart has to say, to share, to give away. So we are blessed to have your presence with us, and we're blessed to have the sisterhood that we're enjoying and embracing together. And on the count of three. Yes. One, two, three.
We change the world!
Thank you, Elise, for an amazing yoga class.
Yes, love you, Elise! I love your feet and I love you.
They're so tiny and cute.
I know. Can't stand it.
It was time. It was time because it happened.
It was beautiful. It was a great show.
So cool. It's time. That's so
happy. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's so awesome.
Thank you. We heal each other.
Yes, we do.